Now, you loved her without a trace.
You loved her. Yeah.
You loved her the most.
I love her in real life, guys.
Good.
Can you believe this? My beautiful, multi-talented wife is here,
oh
right?
Oh, my God.
Yeah. This is cute.
That was cute. Thank you.
No arguments last night, so this is a good day for all of us. We're going to have a nice interview.
Okay, good.
Oh, so, well, we're here. Well, you're here.
I'm here.
To join us and talk about this children's book that we actually wrote together.
Oh, fantastic.
I don't want to be chump change on this. I did put in some time on the book.
Yeah?
You did.
We wrote this book, and why don't you talk to us a little bit about it?
Our daughter, Sabella. She's five. Five, right?
Five and a half?
Yes.
It's early.
Okay.
It's
early. You know, like every parent, you read children's books at night, right? And we realized, and being Latina, that there was nothing in the market that catered to Latin rhythms and Latin music. It's all, everything is about ballet and like tap. So we just came up with this idea of doing something that introduced kids to ballroom dancing at a very, very early age and learn about samba and cha-cha-cha and merengue. And then hopefully at some point we'll do one about salsa and paso doble and tango and things like that. And it's called Sebi and the Land of Cha-Cha-Cha. Her name is Isabella. We call her Sebi. And it's super cute. We got an illustrator from Puerto Rico because it was very important to me to bring my roots into the whole product. Nivea Ortiz, and we're very proud of it. We're very happy. Comes out September 5th.
It's got a great look. Did you go through the drawings, or how did you get?
Oh yeah, very specific. We got a lot of sketches from the illustrator. Yeah, it was a crazy process because I wanted to kind of resemble Sabella, but not be Sabella. I wanted to be kind of like cute, and we went through a lot of different. Yeah, and then we came. This is the final thing. Look at her right
there.
Oh my God.
This was a funny little thing this was my wife's idea, but we put together a dance video with her and some of her best friends, sort of teaching basic steps to the cha-cha song.
There is nothing cuter than to see little girls in their tutus and dancing around.
So great.
There's nothing.
It's so great.
They had never done anything like this.
So when you get the book, at the back, it's going to have a link with that class. And the funny thing is that we could have gone with like professional ballroom dancers.
Yeah.
They exist at 5 and 6 years old, kids that are incredible.
Wow.
But we're like, no, to make it relatable to parents, let's just have Sabella and her best friends in real life do it. They don't even know what merengue is, right? So they do it. The class is a hot mess, but it's cute. It's so cute.
We did bring a little professional, pair to come in and show them, like, hey, if you work hard, you could actually dance like this.
Yeah.
And my daughter's reaction was, we don't stand a chance.
That is funny.
We're like, this is a competition.
Roselyn, you are a dancer, right?
Yes, I grew up dancing.
Now, what about Eric? Can he merengue
dance my whole
and
life.
Salsa? And
well,
okay,
that's,
in the club. Okay.
Yeah. I want
to tell you something. I'm begging him to do, and I'm gonna plug it right here. Oh, look at me. I wanted to do Dancing with the Stars. I'm going.
Yes,
do it.
Let's start the campaign.
Yes, I'm dedicated
you
to your daughter.
Don't get too big for it. Don't get too big for it.
I said you have a reason. There's a reason for it. You're doing it for your daughter. You
One
have a book about dancing.
Here's a little insight. We actually did dance a cha-cha at our wedding.
Yeah.
And I was petrified. Like we danced a cha-cha and a foxtrot.
Yeah. Whew.
Still gives you shivers.
Still blows me away.
We rehearsed for like 2 months, and he will show up at rehearsal miserable, like embarrassing. Yeah. And the choreographer, the teacher is like, this guy's, it's like annoyed. And I'm going, listen to me, you have to do something about it. So I said, Eric, do it like you're making fun of yourself. Just be stupid. Just do it.
Yeah.
And he's like, what, you want me to go like this? And I said, exactly.
That's it.
That's it.
That's it.
And then everything changed.
In the end,
it was great.
Everybody loved it.
Yeah. So don't take yourself so seriously.
One thing to add about the book, too, is it is in Spanish and in English, and that's a big part of our household, and our daughter's bilingual, and we just wanted to make sure.
He's taking Spanish classes.
I am.
After 12 years, finally.
It's tough.
Has it rubbed off?
It's tough.
Well, when Sabella and Rosalind speak in Spanish,
you
don't know what they're saying about you.
I'm out. And she talks very fast. So I'm hearing and understanding much more of the conversation than I actually
especially would. Especially tones, right?
Oh, yeah. Then I know if I'm in trouble, if it's a good day, bad day.
He knows all the bad words.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I do.
All that, he knows all the bad words.
We don't have to talk about that. But look.
So it comes out September 5th, but people can pre-order the book. There's the link right there.
Oh,
exactly.
So sweet.
Yes.
It'll be National Hispanic Heritage Month, like she said, September 5th. The link is on the screen. You can also go to Amazon or penguin.com and get the book there.
Now, your daughter's watching, yes?
Maybe. I hope so.
Yeah. Okay.
Sebi, are you watching?
She's watching cartoons.
Sabella?
Better,
whatever
it is. I don't know, but yeah.
Sebi.
You're right.
Yes.
Right.
Oh, it's just mom click.
You're right.
Thank you guys
thank
so much.
Thank you for coming
really
in.
Nice.
And thank you for sitting in for Sam. That's awesome.
Yeah, of course. Eric, we'll see
well
you
done. You guys,
thank
you okay? Yeah.
Okay. You made it. Coming up in Escape.